Hey, my crafty friends. I am back with a story kit crush layout. This is a very, very inspired by Denine Marie. I believe that's how you pronounce it. It's denine2 on Instagram. I believe she was celebrating, I believe her 51st birthday, and I had just had a birthday, so I was like, oh, this is perfect, and a good way to put another story into August. So I am using my digital kit, the U kit, I believe is what it was, the U story kit, for that 3x4 card over there. I probably won't be able to link it, unfortunately. She only puts the story kit, like the story kits, in the shop for like revisit sales and stuff, but is definitely in the U kit, and I'm sure you could find like other things for this, but this was just a picture I had taken right around my birthday, and I just wanted to jot a few things down at 37, and I thought that this was like a perfect spread to do this with. So here I am. I am using one of the pocket liners or the pocket protectors that has like the 4x6 on top with the 6 2x2s on bottom. And I just taped those two cards together so they weren't all fluctuating in there. And yeah, so I just used one of the chipboard pieces over there. I think it says like, I will choose you a million times over or something like that from the U kit. And then I took a few of these heart chipboard pieces from the digital kit. And usually when I do chipboard pieces, I run it through my silhouette and then I cut out that same shape a few times in the paper just to get that chipboard texture. Even though I am putting these in the 2x2 pockets, I just figured that I would give it a little bit more texture. So I started this one and was like, oh, how am I going to do this? I decided to pull out my tiny attacher and do it that way. I am not sure why I didn't put them on the outside of the page protector. I don't know. I'd already put everything else on the page protector, so I thought that maybe it would look weird. Because then I was like, oh, I wanted to put some phrase stickers over this, but it is what it is. It's all good. But this comes together pretty quick. This side does. It's the other side that definitely takes a little bit more time. So right here, I am using the Ellie Edwards numbers from a December daily kit, probably, I don't know, at this point, probably 2-3 years ago. I do believe I will be able to link these. I do believe these are in the shop along with the digital portion of this too. I actually think I have the digital version of this too. But yeah, so just using that, I am using all close to my heart inks. Yes, I believe I do. So this blue is Glacier. I will also link this below. The next color was Sorbet, the pink color. Did I use Honey or Gold Rush? I believe I used Honey. I guess we're going to have to see here in a half a second. Oh, I meant to cut this editing part out. I have no idea why I left this part in here. All right, here we go. It's going to play. Okay, so this one is, yep, like I said, Sorbet. And then, what other color did I use? I was trying to match the colors of that card as close as I could. So we'll just wait. So there's that Sorbet. It does, these inks, as you will see, they do spread and like melt into the paper a little bit more and spread out. This is what I love about these inks. These are just regular dye inks. But this is probably my biggest collection that I have of inks. I am starting to do distress oxides and distress inks. Oh, it was right there and I missed it. Okay, it was never on screen. I had to go back and see the video again. It never does come on screen. I'm like 95% sure that was Honey for that yellow. Yeah, I believe it was honey to get that yellow. I could not match that yellow with the inks that I had. I actually never even tried my distress inks because I didn't want it to look like the chalky. I wanted it to kind of be that more brilliant color. And then that pink color is blush, I believe. It was blush or pixie. Those two are pretty close. I can't remember exactly. So I just used those stamps and stamped all over the paper, leaving a little spot. I'm sorry, I'm going to go off screen a little bit here. But leaving a space at the middle for my 37, just like she did. As you can see, I'm leaving that 7 up there. I went to almost put it away and I'm like, wait, I need that. I am just going to stamp the 3 and the 7 in the blank ink by close to my heart. Here it is right here. Fussy cut those out, which, let me tell you, that wasn't the easiest thing in the world, since those little spots down there, like the lines, are super, super tiny. So it was not the easiest. I am using a mouse pad because I definitely wanted this to be nice and bold, and I didn't get out my stamp, whatever you want to call that, like my Misty. I don't have a Misty, but it's a off brand of that. So I didn't want to have to re-stamp it. So both of those came out real good. I knew that they had already been primed and used many, many of times, so I didn't think that I would have an issue, but I definitely wanted to use that mouse pad to make sure I got a good impression the first time. So, all right. So here I am about to fussy cut that. I will edit that out though, because that was painstakingly tough. I don't mind fussy cutting. I just watch a show at that point. So I did want to do a little bit of dimension on these to make it even more dramatic, I guess I should say, with the black ink against, you know, all those pastels. And so I did pop this up on foam tape. I believe that this is just 1/4 inch foam tape. And as you can see at this point, that orange has definitely dulled down a little bit. Even the yellow has dulled down a little bit and sunk into that paper, and it's beautiful. For this paper, I don't believe I used anything special, just regular cardstock. I could have, I guess, pulled out my Nina bright white paper, but it is what it is. I know that this paper does good for stamping also, so I wasn't that worried about it. So I did pull out some dots to just get on those. They were like perfect, for that 3 to pop dot that. And it just worked out much easier than doing the straight foam. So otherwise, this spread came together quite well. You will see me here in a minute go through my stash of like chipboard and labels and everything, because I knew it needed a little bit. I believe where I pulled one out was an L Studio die cut, I believe from probably like the January kit, because it was more geared towards like the new year and all that kind of stuff. But I believe here in a second, it just says, oh, I did have to move. As you can see, that popped out a little bit because I didn't want it to hurt the 7. But as you can see, that 3 is super flimsy. And I wanted to get it just right without tearing it. I was like terrified that I was going to tear it. But all goes well. There we go. All set down. And I love it. I love how it stands out so much and works well. So, all right, I think it says it's going to be a great year. This little die cut, it will drop in here in a second. Yep. Oh, yeah. See, I did want to show you that I was going through several different chipboard pieces. That kind of stuff is from Paper Person, from their like morning kit that I legit still haven't used. There we go. It's going to be a good year. There we go. Yes, because I am trying to make this the best year still. I know as women approach 30, I know hopefully this is what other people, that it just, that number gets a little daunting, and turning 37 has just been a bit crazy for me. So pop dotting that also, getting that up there, especially with, you know, my oldest getting older in high school and all that good stuff. So just a lot of different emotions happening, right? All right, so that is pretty much the end of it. I'm just going to use that page protector to punch my holes. And at the end of this, there will be a still image because I actually remembered to take that for you guys. And yeah, I hope you guys love the spread. And again, thank you. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right, Denine, for all of the inspiration. Keep it coming. Talk to you guys soon. Bye.